Peripheral arterial disease, or PAD, is a disease of the blood vessels not involving the heart. PAD is typically caused by a buildup of plaque within the body's artery walls, causing a lack of oxygen and blood flow primarily to the legs. Dr. Peter Chaille explains that while the symptoms are often subtle, they should never be ignored.
Unlike a heart attack, when you have an acute event or something where you know there's a problem developing, PAD is a little bit more slow onset. A lot of times you don't realize that you have it right away. The symptoms can start to manifest over a long period of time. Symptoms can include anything from just my legs feel tired when I walk. The most common symptoms that we think about are my legs cramp. I get a Charlie horse when I walk and when I exert myself. When I stop, the symptoms seem to get better. When I take a break and relax, that cramping tends to go away. But when I get up and walk again, it'll come back. Sometimes it can affect one leg, sometimes it can affect both. But again, the symptoms aren't always specific. It's not always cramping, it's not always fatigue. Sometimes when it gets severe, people who don't really have a lot of those symptoms leading up can develop numbness, tingling in their legs, and they can even start to develop sores or wounds that have a difficult time healing. And those are the ones that we really need to watch for.
How is a patient diagnosed with PAD?
There are some specific tests that we order and we can use to really make a diagnosis. And they're actually some pretty simple tests. One of the most common and most simple tests we can use is called an ABI, which is an ankle brachial index, which is actually a very simple test where we check the blood pressure of the arm and we compare it to the blood pressure of the leg. The blood pressure of the arm is supposed to be very similar to the blood pressure of the leg. There really should be no difference. But if that blood pressure in the leg is much lower than what we're seeing with the arm, that's a tip-off that somewhere in the circulation there's a dam in the river where you're not getting enough circulation to that area, and that allows us to make that diagnosis and look into it a little bit further.
While everyone should be aware of the signs and symptoms of PAD, those who smoke or have diabetes are at a higher risk of the condition. Dr. Chaille explains that treatment often means eliminating risk factors and adopting a healthy fitness routine.
We just assume, well, if there's a blockage, we should fix it. But in peripheral arterial disease, that's not always the case. First and foremost, the treatment of peripheral arterial disease is eliminating those risk factors, eliminating those things which can cause it in the first place. So the most important treatment is stop smoking. If you're a diabetic, make sure that your diabetes is well treated. If you have high cholesterol, treat your high cholesterol. If you have high blood pressure, treat your high blood pressure. So those are the first and foremost things. Likewise, and everybody talks about exercise, but exercise is extremely important in peripheral arterial disease. Not only does it help to prevent further progression of peripheral arterial disease, it's also one of the best treatments for the symptoms. People always think, well, when I walk, it hurts, so maybe I shouldn't walk. Well, the opposite's actually true. The more you walk, the more conditioned you become and the better it is for the circulation. So walking is actually the best treatment that anyone can do for peripheral arterial disease outside of stopping smoking and outside of taking care of those risk factors like treating your diabetes.
Dr. Chaille recommends getting treatment immediately if you notice symptoms of PAD in order to prevent more severe issues down the road, such as a stroke or heart attack.
There are millions of people who are affected by peripheral arterial disease. And as we age, it becomes even much more common. So by the time we hit 65, 1 in 5 people is affected by peripheral arterial disease. And so it's very important that we understand that it exists, we understand what the risk factors are, who's at risk of developing peripheral arterial disease, what we can do to identify it, and what we can do to help treat it. So awareness is very important so that we can get to your physician and make the diagnosis and institute the right treatments so that we can help prevent a problem later on down the road.
This has been Making the Rounds, brought to you by Parkview Health.